Well, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is in China attempting to strengthen ties with the number three trading partner, China, of course. Dan Katarivas is the head of international relations for the Manufacturers Association of Israel. He also led the original Israeli business outreach to China back in 1992. And earlier today, I spoke with him about what Israel hopes to accomplish this week in China.
China, as everybody knows, is a huge country, an economy that is booming, and we as a small country are looking for markets, and I'm sure that on a purely economic level, Mr. Netanyahu is looking for expansion, deepening and enlarging the economic ties between Israel and China. Well, I know that there is probably also a political aspect to that visit, but I'm more concentrated on the economy, on the developing economic ties.
And what would be some tangible takeaways of progress made by the Prime Minister while he's in China?
Well, there is one thing on the table. We would like to open negotiation for a free trade agreement between us and China. I know that this is part of the things that maybe our Prime Minister would raise with the Chinese leadership. I know the Chinese leadership, they are trying to increase the number of Chinese workers that could come over to Israel. Those are very tangible things. But beside that, the whole idea is actually to make more, I would say, branding Israel as a place for innovation for the Chinese company, which are looking for investing all around the world, and why not to come invest in Israeli innovative companies and technology, and also for Israeli companies which are usually exporting to the American or European markets, and those markets, as I don't have to tell you, are not exactly booming markets. We are looking for diversifying our export markets, and definitely China can be a base both for export, for production, and for joint ventures and working together to the global market.
And since Israel already supplies electrical circuits as well as chemicals, fertilizers to China, what are some of the other areas where Israel is looking to expand in its trade with China?
And we would like to expand to other areas like medical equipment, like water technology, like various ICT type of system, environmental technology. So there is plenty of other areas, agriculture, which we have definitely a very advanced type of agriculture that we can maybe try to work together with the Chinese on developing and implementing them in China. So beside those two areas that you've mentioned, chemicals and IC, integrated circuit, which actually it's an Intel plant which exists in Israel that is exporting to its plant in China. We are trying to expand and to diversify in order to have a much healthier trade relation than we have today.
And looking at U.S. companies like General Motors, one of the lessons have been that the Chinese want the production to actually occur in China. That's why GM is opening plants and in turn it's selling cars there. So what's the model for Israel? How would Israel necessarily do the same thing?
Well, we are not a country that has big plants and big production. We are good at innovation. We are good at developing a new product in R&D. So eventually the cooperation definitely can be Israel R&D and Chinese production. So we're not talking here about actually moving production plant from Israel to China, because we don't have a cheap labor here. We're not big producer. We are probably good inventors, and this complementarity between Israeli capacity and Chinese capacity, this is definitely a win-win situation.
And would Israel necessarily be looking for a direct Chinese investment into Israeli startups and R&D businesses?
As long as they respect the rules of the game, as long as issue of IP are respected, as long as there is a real benefit for the two parties, why not?